Okay, so what last time we were discussing was the exercises. We've discussed about part third. Now this is part fourth, means actually we are having a continuation series of the same exercise. So at least by now we'll be able to complete it. So part fourth, we are going to begin for exercises. The question we were dealing last time was question number 8. And we were trying to understand how to calculate the area under this graph. So we had come to the conclusion that at least we need to calculate area particularly present under that curve for 4 seconds. And for that, we were trying to calculate with the help of number of boxes. So that we knew to calculate distance, we need to calculate distance from this graph, then we need to take area. But we cannot take area directly. So what we did, we were trying to find out number of boxes here, number of boxes we were able to find. And how many those boxes were? 62. So 62 box into area of one box, that is a formula, but that is rectangle. What is the area of rectangle? Length into breadth, that we also know, length into breadth. But we need to know the values of length and breadth, only then we'll be able to calculate. Now how to do that? It's the same kind of problem which we were trying to solve for that previous graph question, question number 6. To calculate value of one box, that is very much simple, all you have to do is compare the values. Now we need length and we need breadth. Two values we require. Theek hai? That means value of x-axis and value of y-axis. Because on y-axis you will get width, that is breadth, and on x-axis you will get length. So two values we are requiring. So let us start on x-axis and y-axis. Now how to find out those? All you have to do is find number of boxes and the value. Now the first value which you can see on x-axis is 2. Forget about that 0. After 0, the first value you are able to see is 2 seconds. Now from this 2 seconds, you can calculate length of one box. Now to do that, first you have to find out how many boxes make 2 seconds. So how many boxes make 2 seconds? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I have written here 5. 5 boxes makes 2 seconds. So that is exactly what I have written. See, 5 boxes makes 2 seconds. Now what about on y-axis? How many boxes makes 2 meter per second? So 1, 2 and 3. I have written 3. So 3 boxes makes 2 meter per second. 3 boxes makes 2 meter per second. Okay, that is a very simple thing. All we have done it is we have calculated number of boxes and their values and we have put it. We are interested to know what is the length of one box and what is the breadth of one box. So we will say one box length, one box width. And as we don't know the value, we will put a question mark there. Now these kind of things are something looking like direct relationship. You had a lesson called as direct and inverse relationship in class 8 in mathematics. Same procedure you have to follow, direct relationship. All you have to do is cross multiply. So what will be the cross multiplication? Question mark into 5 and is equal to 2 into 1. But what I will do, for x axis, I will just call it length. Because at least one side I have to consider it as length, other side will become width. Theek hai? Ya fir breadth. So that you have to understand. I am assuming that one side is length. So I am just considering whatever is present on x-axis, that is length. And other factor, that is other dimension, will directly become what? Width. So I will just try to calculate length here. So I will just give that name as LX. Length on x-axis is equals to, you can just write down L here. I have written X because students should not get confused. I am finding out the length with the help of x-axis. That's why I have written LX. That is actually not necessary. You can just write down L there. It's up to you. Now LX is equals to 2 into 1 divided by 5. 2 into 1 divided by 5. So 2 by 5 is nothing but 0.4. 2 by 5 is nothing but 0.4 seconds. In the same way, we are going to calculate from y-axis. We are going to get width. So what I will do, I will use the word B there. Okay, that is breadth. Breadth from y-axis. Okay, breadth from y-axis. Again, it is not necessary for you to write down why. I am writing this because student will directly understand that this breadth has been calculated from y-axis. It's up to you. Now how to multiply? 2 into 1 divided by 3 on y-axis. Just cross multiply. 2 into 1 divided by 3. So 2 by 3 is how much? 0.666, right? So that would be 0.666 meter per second. So give me response in chat box. Have you understood how we are actually trying to calculate these values, box values of one and the second one, length as well as breadth? Okay, Yash, is it clear again? Now, Urjit, fine. Okay, so let us proceed again. Now, with these values, all we have to do is put them in the in our actual formula. So we will just use these values and put it here. What is the length? 0.4. And what is the breadth? 0.666. Let us just put those. So it will become 62 into length is 0.4, breadth is 0.666. We will multiply 62 and 0.4 first. So we'll multiply, that will become 24.8. 24.8 into 0.666. So the final answer would be 16.5168 meters. Okay? I have calculated it very accurately, but you can do one thing. There is actually no need for the extra two decimals. All I require is, after every decimal, I require two values, that is 51. So even if your answer is 16.51, still you will get the marks. And due to the nature of these calculations, sometimes it might happen that your answer is coming as 16.53 or 16.49 or 16.52. That is also correct. Okay, these kind of accuracies happen because of this calculation. Because some students might take it 0.66, some student might take it 4, 6, 6, 6, 6, and 6. So hence try to understand that even if your answer is 16.50, 53, 54, those variations in the answer come because of these decimal points of 6. So marks will be given for every answer, don't worry. All you need to do is do your calculations correctly. Some kind of variation, that is totally acceptable. Okay, now let us proceed for the next question. Take a screenshot of this. Okay, yes. And Kotwal, what are you asking? What about Homi Baba? Okay, Homi Baba will be starting after, suppose, let us say 1 or 2 days. Problem was, I wanted to start it before 2 weeks, but your classes were going on, suppose class 9, you were having almost like 3 periods in the morning, 2 periods in the evening, and when physics period was there, you were attending almost 6 periods in a day. I didn't want to burden you with your extra lectures. So as every student is free now, there are no lectures from the school in the month of May. We'll be starting soon. Every student will be getting a proper notification regarding it on WhatsApp. Okay? And just follow the instructions, whatever those are put, whatever the instructions are given, just follow them. We'll be starting them within 1 or 2 days. Okay? Max to max, 3 days. Max to max. Okay, let us start. The second question is, which part of the graph represents uniform motion of the car? They are just asking which part of this graph represents uniform motion. Now, to have uniform motion, so that means distance traveled in that case was same. Distance should be same, right? This is speed time graph. So that means we should get a straight line. We should get a straight line. If you want to know uniform motion, we should get a straight line. Because in uniform motion, it is covering equal distance in equal time. And you can see the distance is increasing. Okay, this is non-uniform motion. This is a curved line. We need a straight line. So that means this is straight line is starting from which second? It is starting from 6th second. You might be thinking, sir, but it is, suppose let's say we can start from here. Actually, we cannot. Because there is a curve which is ending at 6th second. So the answer for this question would be from 6th to 10th second, that is uniform motion. So let me highlight it. So that is from 6th to 10th second. Actually, that motion is ending here, but as they have given figures till 10, we can just conclude that these values are available till 10th second. So just write down the answer as, which part of the graph represents uniform motion? Uniform motion of this car is represented by the part from t is equal to 6 seconds to t is equal to 10th second. That is your answer. Okay, so take a screenshot of this. We'll move to the next one. Question number 9th is somewhat theoretical. It is, suppose it's not a numerical, they are just asking examples for these situations. So you have to just give an example for each of the situations. This is not a numerical, this is a theoretical question. So the first question they're asking is, give example. So they are asking us if following situations are possible, then first we have to answer whether it is possible, this situation. And then if it is possible, we have to give an example for it. That is the question. So first subbit is, an object with a constant acceleration but with zero velocity. Okay? I hope you understood the question. The question is, an object with a constant acceleration but with zero velocity. Okay? So you have to understand what they're saying, that the acceleration should be constant but the velocity should be zero. Okay? Acceleration is constant but velocity is zero. So a simple example for this would be what? That acceleration due to gravity example, when the ball is thrown up or when the ball is thrown down. In both the cases, somewhere you will get a velocity zero. For example, if you throw a ball from the top of the building, the ball will be at rest initially. So initial velocity would be zero, but it would have acceleration. That acceleration of the body it received was due to gravity. Okay, Earth is pulling that ball. It had zero velocity initially because it was at rest, but it got acceleration due to what? Due to gravity of the Earth. To try to understand, that is one example. Another example is what? When a ball is thrown up, it stops at a particular maximum height, right? It reaches to a maximum height and then it starts falling. That is the general behavior. When you throw a ball, it will reach some height, it will stop there, and then it will start falling. So at that moment, when that ball stops for a second at the maximum height, the velocity becomes zero. That is the final velocity. So that example also you can write. At that time, final velocity is zero, but it is still facing acceleration. And that's a constant acceleration due to gravity. So this situation is possible. And you can give examples of either throwing a ball from the top of the building or suppose, let's say, throwing from the bottom. That is up to you. So when you can say it is possible, situation is possible. When the ball is just released from the height, then it is being acted by a constant acceleration. That is due to gravity. That is 9.8 meter per second square. But its initial velocity is zero. Venkatesh, what are you asking? Speed is changed. Definitely speed is changing. We are talking about a specific moment. I have taught you something called as instantaneous speed. Instantaneous speed means what? Speed at a particular juncture. So we are not talking about the complete journey of the ball. We are just talking about that one moment where the velocity was zero. We are not talking about the complete journey. We are talking only about one particular moment. That is what exactly we have written here. When a ball is just released from a height, then it is being acted by a constant acceleration, but its initial velocity is zero. Focus here. I have written initial velocity is zero. I have not said velocity is zero. I have said initial velocity is zero. I am talking about a specific moment. ठीक है, एक particular हिस्से की बात कर रहा हूँ मैं. I am not talking about complete journey. That cannot be the example of this. Understood, Venkatesh? Okay, now let us move to the second question. Second question is, we have to give example for an object moving with acceleration but with uniform speed. Means uniform speed means what? That it is having, suppose let us say the speed is increasing constantly, and they are saying acceleration is there. That means acceleration is neither zero and it is not neither constant. Acceleration is changing. So that object is under some acceleration, but it has uniform speed. What do you think can be the example of this? Speed is, suppose let's say there is hardly any change, but acceleration is changing. Can somebody give example for this? Actually, we have studied this topic. We have taken a separate session on this. A body changing its acceleration constantly, but with uniform speed. Urjit, what are you giving example? A car in autopilot. Okay. No, you are not understanding here. Yes, Tanmay, that is correct. Tanmay's answer is very much correct. Answer is circular motion. Answer is circular motion. Why? Because see, what they are saying is uniform speed. So they are saying without changing the speed, you have to change the acceleration. If that is the case, that means you need to change direction. Only then you can have acceleration without compromising your speed. So speed is remaining same. All you are talking about is changing acceleration without changing speed. That is possible if you change direction constantly. That happens only in circular motion. So example for this is, this situation is totally possible and answer would be circular motion. Circular motion is the example of an object in which it is moving with acceleration but with uniform speed. Speed is uniform in that case. So take a screenshot of this. Do not get confused. We have to keep uniform speed, but we have to change acceleration. That can happen if we change direction. And we have taken a separate class on this circular motion. How come you are not able to give answer for this? Just apply your logic. And Tanmay, congratulations. At least you are paying attention. You know, nothing gives joy to a teacher than his students giving proper answers. So I am very much happy that at least, you know, at least one student was able to give proper answer. Students try to understand physics is not like your regular subject. It is not like your chemistry, it's not like your bio, wherein you would memorize the things and you'll be able to answer. To give answers in physics, you will require conceptual understanding. You will be required to study more. Even if you attend my lectures, even if I'm giving, suppose, let's say, in-depth discussion about the topic, you still need to learn it again on your own. You have to self-learn, you have to study on your own again. Theek hai? So, what I recommend is revise this topic again. Do not consider physics as a regular subject and do not take it lightly. Many students, like you know, like your previous batches, have taken physics lightly and they have paid dearly for it. Let me tell you, this physics is very much hard because first, it's a science subject. Second thing, it has mathematics also. That is one of the reasons what makes physics difficult. Physics is a science based on maths. Try to understand. Hence, conceptual understanding is somewhat difficult in this case. So pay proper attention. Let us go for the third question now. Third bit. In third bit, they are saying an object moving in a certain direction with acceleration in the perpendicular direction. So they are saying an object is moving in a certain direction. So that object has a certain direction, but that acceleration has a perpendicular direction. So that means they are saying the direction of the object, that means the velocity of the object, and the acceleration are having perpendicular angle. Who is having perpendicular angle? Acceleration and the object moving. Object moving means what? Velocity. So velocity and acceleration are having perpendicular direction. This kind of example they're asking. Now I can understand that you are not able to give answer for this because the answer for this is again same. It is circular motion. Let me explain you how come there is a perpendicular direction between acceleration of velocity in circular motion. So I hope you remember our exercise activity, that is activity 8.11. In that case, what that boy was trying to do, he had tied that stone and he was whirling around himself. And that stone, it was moving in circles. Try to understand when we were trying to cut that particular line, that stone was going to go tangential. Theek hai? So at this instant, the velocities, this green arrow is nothing but direction of velocity of this particular stone at this particular juncture. But suppose let us say, if this particular boy, suppose let's say you are practicing this particular thing at your home, you are moving a stone around yourself, and if you stop in between, if you stop in between, have you realized that that stone is trying to come to your own place? Theek hai? That stone will do what? Its energy will decrease and it will try to come to your place. Theek hai? Why it is happening? Because it is facing acceleration towards inside. So you have to understand one more thing about circular motion, that its velocity is in some direction, but it will always face acceleration towards the center. Towards the center acceleration there will be, and that is called a centripetal acceleration. try to understand this. What is that concept? They are saying that acceleration is towards the center. Acceleration is towards the center. That happens because the force is from this side, so acceleration will always be towards the center. But that object will always have velocity in the other direction. And what is this angle? Okay, what is this angle? This black line is acceleration. This green arrow is velocity. And what is this angle? Perpendicular. Always remember this angle is perpendicular. That is 90 degree. So answer for this C subbit is this situation is possible. And this situation is possible in which case? Circular direction. Okay, circular motion. So when an object moves in circular path, its direction along the tangent of the circle and acceleration is towards the radius of the circle. Acceleration is towards the radius of the circle. Always remember that. And that is nothing but the perpendicular angle between the two. Okay? So give me response in chat box. Have you understood this? That there is a perpendicular angle between acceleration and velocity of the object in circular motion. Okay, very simple concept to understand. Just remember that. Now let us go for the 10th question. The last one. I will just give you idea about this, but you have to do the calculations. Okay? At least that I should expect because this is the last question of our exercise. We have taught, I have completely taught this particular topic. So at least you should be able to answer this, right? So let me just give you the idea about this first. What they are saying, an artificial satellite is, suppose let's say orbiting the Earth of radius 42250 kilometers. So an artificial satellite. Satellite means what? An object which is, suppose let's say smaller in size as compared to a planet. And this is artificial. Artificial means what? Man-made. So they are saying an artificial satellite is moving in a circular orbit of radius 42250 kilometers. Next they are saying calculate its speed if it takes 24 hours to revolve around the Earth. So what they are saying, calculate the speed if it takes 24 hours to revolve around the Earth. So there is an artificial satellite. They have given us the radius of the path. They're just asking to calculate speed. So let's just try to understand the situation. This is the situation. This is planet Earth. This is our orbit. And this is our satellite, artificial satellite. Next thing they are saying, this radius from the center of the Earth, because they have given radius of what? Radius of circular orbit. They have not given radius of Earth. They have given us radius of circular orbit. That means from the center of the Earth, the radius is 42250. So let me show you what is that distance we are talking about. From the center of the Earth towards that satellite, the distance is 42250 kilometers. Now they are saying how much time this particular satellite is taking to complete one round. It is taking 24 hours. 24 hours. They are just asking speed. Now it's a very simple formula. You are learning about the speed formula from your sixth grade. Speed is equal to what? Distance by time. That we already know. But before that, we will write down the given data. What is radius? 42250 kilometers. But we do not generally use kilometers. We have to convert it into meters. So 42250 into 10 to the power 3. Kilo means what? 1000, 10 to the power 3 meters. What about time? Time is given as 24 hours. But also remember, we do not use time in hours. We need to convert it into seconds. So 24 into 60 into 60. Now, what is the formula for speed? Speed is equal to distance by time. But you can see the distance traveled in this case is circumference. And what is the formula for circumference? You can see this is a circular motion, no? So what is the distance traveled? Distance traveled in one round is nothing but circumference here. And for circumference, we have a formula 2 pi r. So formula will become 2 pi r divided by t. All you have to do is place the values there. So we'll place. So that is 2 into pi value is 22 by 7 into radius is 42250 into 10 to the power 3 divided by what is the time? 24 into 60 into 60. We have converted into seconds. Now you do the calculations and tell me the speed in meter per second. I have given you all the things. I have given you formula. I have given you values. I have given you everything. All you have to do is calculate. Okay, Samale, what your given answer? 1747.83 kilometer per hour. No, you need to calculate in terms of meter per second. That is exactly for what this question is given. So that student should be able to understand how to calculate in meter per second. So please change your values and make sure that it is in meter per second. Okay, Riya Killare, how much is your answer? 3070.9 meter per second. Jayesh, 3073.74 meter per second. Shivam, 3073.74 meter per second. Okay. Okay, students, take time. Okay? Give proper answers. What about other students? Other students are still doing their calculations. Okay, Tanmay, how much you have given? 3070.949. Okay. Rushikesh, how much you have given answer? No, your answer seems wrong. Your answer is in 5 digits, 30737. Other students have given their answers in 4 digits. 3000 ka range mein bataya baaki ke bachchon ne. Your answer is in 30,000. Kindly check your decimal point again. There might be some mistake. Somani, check your decimal point again. There might be some mistake there. Urjit, how much you have given? 3070.93. Okay, so many students have given answer. Let us check our final answer. What is the final answer? Final answer is 3073.7433. But it is fine even if your answer is 3073 and suppose though other decimals are suppose somewhat different, it is totally fine. Okay, Rushikesh, now your answer is very much correct. 743. Okay, fine. Up to 2 digits I want after the decimal, and you can skip the later part. These 3 and 3 are not necessary, that is just for accuracy, but I am expecting after decimal there should be 2 points at least. Venkatesh, what kind of answer is that? How much big that answer is? 1 2 3 4 5 6. How come your answer is in 7 digits? Are you answering some different question? Okay, so final answer is what? Speed is equal to 3073.7433 meter per second.